Hoare wasn't alone. Across the estates of Britain, naturalistic landscape gardens became the height of fashion. And today, gardening has become a national obsession, the way that so many of us attempt to make nature our own. But while most of our gardens are simply there for pleasure, one artist has attempted to go further. I've come to a modern garden in Dumfriesshire to meet a man who has done things that would astonish even Henry Hoare. This is the garden of cosmic speculation, and there is no mistaking the human hand here. It's as far from a naturalistic garden as it's possible to get. And yet it is based on the underlying principles of nature itself. The fractals, black holes and waveforms that form our understanding of the universe. This extraordinary garden was created by the landscape artist, architect and theorist Charles Jenks. Born in America, Jenks began developing the garden at his home in Scotland in 1988.
I think when you see the sun go down and you see the earth form these pathways, and the light is at the top, you definitely feel as if you belonged here, as if this is a part of you. It's not just a projection, it's kind of a deep feeling. And I think you get that in landscape. And you don't get it in any art that is not bigger than you.
More recently, Jenks has completed a new work, the Croic Multiverse, a monumental series of landforms in Dumfriesshire. It references so many ancient monuments, stone circles, long barrows and burial mounds. But this is inspired by the science of our own age. So how do you see your relationship to nature?
Well, we're part of nature, but as religions have always said, we're different from nature. And I think both are very deep insights. And so a landscape art, and art in general, should show that very strange human relationship to the universe that is both feeling at home and feeling separate from it.
I know that everything here has multiple meanings.
Yes.
But what are you trying to achieve with this garden?
Well, I'm trying to achieve the old idea that we're partly at home in the universe and we should celebrate that. And if you haven't enjoyed it and found it amusing and colorful and sensuous and delightful, it should do all of that. So I think if you're not happy in this garden, I failed.
I don't think Charles Jenks has failed. What he has achieved both here and at the Croic Multiverse is hugely impressive. Charles Jenks's garden is a microcosm of the universe itself. Now, of course, it's absurdly grandiose, of course it is, but in a way, all gardens are worlds within worlds. All gardens are ways by which humans try to negotiate a place for themselves amid the mysteries of nature. The garden is our most explicit attempt not simply to reshape nature, but to possess it. But while we can possess the land, one natural realm will forever elude us. It is a strange thing how little in general people know about the sky. It is the part of creation in which nature has done more for the sake of pleasing man, more for the sole and evident purpose of talking to him and teaching him than in any other of her works. And it is just the part in which we least attend to her. There is not a moment of any day of our lives when nature is not producing scene after scene, picture after picture, glory after glory. The noblest scenes of the earth can be seen and known but by few. But the sky is for all. I love these words, written by John Ruskin more than 100 years ago. And he is, of course, right. Too often we ignore the beauty that lies above us. It is indeed the eternal masterpiece. And in the Yorkshire Sculpture Park, one structure has been devised expressly to draw our focus up to the sky. For me, it is one of Britain's most inspiring artworks.
So this is it. It's a small square room, surrounded on all sides by concrete benches. It's a simple place, actually quite understated, but what's important about it, what's beautiful about it, is up there.
This is a sky space by the American artist James Turrell. In the middle of the ceiling, he has cut an aperture that opens directly onto the sky. All he asks his viewers to do is open their eyes and look up. As one slowly adjusts to the scene, one becomes transfixed.
This has been one of the great, great experiences for me. And you know, the sky space does something really miraculous. It makes the sky come indoors. It really feels like the sky is hovering inside this room, that you can even reach up and touch it. And you know, I've been sitting here for a few hours now and watching this incredible drama unfold above me. I've seen this amazing palette of blues change. I've seen clouds scud across the ceiling. And I've seen the odd cameo of birds and jet planes. And you know, it has been gripping, completely gripping throughout. I think one of the lessons that James Turrell teaches you is patience, because you can't just come in here and spend 30 seconds and then walk out again. You have to sit down, you have to look up, and you have to just wait, and you have to adjust to the rhythms of nature. And you know, it reminds me that
The greatest art does something very simple. It makes the familiar seem completely unfamiliar. It makes you see the world in an entirely new way. I couldn't bring myself to leave the sky space, so I stayed on into the evening. And inside, there was more magic to come. As the sun sets, perfectly adjusted lights have a remarkable effect on the colour of the sky at dusk. The sky turns an overwhelmingly intense blue, deepening more and more as the night encroaches. It is like an abstract painting made by nature itself. On my travels around the British Isles, I visited six distinct landscapes, and I've found inspiring and beautiful things everywhere I've gone. I've seen some artworks thrive for decades, and others only last a few moments. I've seen unforgettable, elemental struggles, and peaceful but thought-provoking havens. Each of them taps into our ancient desire to make a mark on the land, while redefining what modern art can be. And each of them finds beauty in a world we often take for granted. Together they prove that art is everywhere. All we need to do is go out into nature and find it.